Get started as a Zoom Rooms admin by setting up the location hierarchy for Zoom Rooms in the web portal. In this video, you'll learn how to create a location hierarchy to define the locations of all your Zoom Rooms. Creating a hierarchy is important so that a Zoom Room can inherit the characteristics from any level above it in the hierarchy. Want to turn on a setting for 25 rooms in a building? Instead of going into each room setting, you can enable the setting at a higher level. This will cascade to all the rooms at a location. On the other hand, you can also turn a setting on or off for a specific room if the setting is not locked at a higher level. Let's dive in. Once you've logged into your admin account from the web portal, go to the left navigation menu and click Room Management, then click Zoom Rooms. On the right side, click Add Location. Here, you'll build the structure for your rooms by choosing the locations you need for your account. Select a country, state, city, campus, building, or floor. This all depends on the size and structure of your organization, so you can select some or all. In this example, we'll build a hierarchy for a university, so let's select all of them. On the right side, you can see what your location structure will look like. Click Save. The Zoom Rooms tab will display a new location directory pane, as well as a set of tabs based on your location structure. One of each structure type will be added automatically. Starting from right to left, click Countries, then click Edit. Click the pencil icon under Country and rename the country. Click Save. Click back to Zoom Rooms. If you need to add any additional countries, you can always come back and click the Add button. This applies to all tabs for the respective structure. Now that we've added the country, let's add a state. Click on the States tab and then click Edit. Click the pencil icon under State Name and rename the state. Click Save. Then click back to Zoom Rooms. Just like the Countries tab, if you have any additional states to add, you can do so by clicking the Add State button. Let's move on to the Cities tab. Rename the city and click back to Zoom Rooms. Next is the Campuses tab. The campus structure can be helpful when you have multiple locations and buildings in each location. Click the Campuses tab, then click Edit and rename the campus. Next, click the Buildings tab. For our example, we'll add two buildings. Let's add the additional building first. Click Add Building and include as much information as you'd like. In this example, for the university, we'll name each building by the school. If you have multiple buildings, you can include the address here to avoid confusion. Sometimes, admins even like to name the building by the address. Click Finish, and next we'll edit Building 1. Now that we have the buildings, let's set up our floors. Click the Floors tab and then click Edit. Rename it or keep it as is and head back to Zoom Rooms. Our location hierarchy is now created, and we can manage settings for each level by clicking the settings in each tab. Finally, we're ready to add some rooms. Click the Rooms tab and then the Add Room button. Here you can select the room type, edit the room name, and even connect to a calendar. You also have the option to select a location and enable hot desking, which is a feature that allows people to reserve a desk or workspace. Let's click Finish. Now you can activate your Zoom Rooms. Happy meeting!